I need you to help me make a fake movie.
I'm doing what I was made to do.
I believe it to be political in nature.
Didn't realize you had such a glass jaw.
Good night.
And good luck.
George Clooney spent 15 years as a journeyman actor in Hollywood, until his role as Dr. Doug Ross on ER changed all that.
I was under contract at Warner Brothers in the television department, and this guy, Jonathan Levy, who was a casting director, leaked me a script to ER. And I auditioned for it, and I got it, got the part.
I didn't know that pediatricians could be so sexy.
After ER, Clooney's acting career blossomed into feature films.
Yeah! That was nothing!
Ted Nugent called. He wants his shirt back.
By the mid-2000s, he was one of the biggest movie stars in the world.
And it made a tremendous difference in my career and the things I wanted to do.
And what Clooney wanted to do was go beyond acting to become a filmmaker. One of his first credits as producer was Christopher Nolan's Insomnia.
What are you going to do, tell him the truth? You shot your partner.
Followed by the caper comedy, Welcome to Collinwood.
Why are you dressed like a priest?
You're an idiot.
Clooney's other producing credits include Rockstar, Rumor Has It, The Informant, and the groundbreaking A Scanner Darkly.
I'm going to tell you what I'm afraid of.
Borrowing a strategy from another Warner Brothers legend, Clooney used his star power to make films that delved into deeper subject matter.
Clint always did that, which was, I'll do a big commercial film, and let me do my little film. And we sort of used that model. We do, all right, we're going to do an Oceans film for you, but then we want to do Michael Clayton here. And everybody said, okay, fair.
One of the first examples of Clooney's commitment as a producer was Syriana, which took an unblinking look at the causes of terrorism.
If we are going to claim a war on terrorism, then you have to understand the enemy, and you have to understand why they do what they do, and not just declare them as evil.
Why are they doing a damage assessment on the Amiris and on me?
This is about our interests in the region.
For his role as Bob Barnes, a world-weary CIA operative, Clooney underwent a remarkable transformation.
I had to put on 30 pounds. I ended up putting on 35 by the end. Grow a beard and shave my hairline back. I probably wouldn't do it again because it really messed with my health, but it was worth doing because I think it's an important film.
For his haunting performance, Clooney won the Academy Award for Best Supporting Actor. That same year, he undertook a project near and dear to his heart.
My father's a journalist, and I knew the Murrow story pretty well. And I started looking for times in our history where standing up against all of those other government entities was life-changing and mattered.
His proposition is very simple. Anyone who criticizes or opposes Senator McCarthy's methods must be a communist. And if that be true, there are an awful lot of communists in this country.
Good Night and Good Luck received 6 Oscar nominations, including 2 for Clooney as co-screenwriter and director. The film has gone on to have a life beyond the movies.
They teach it as a curriculum in schools of journalism, Columbia University and places.
Clooney produced and played the title role in Michael Clayton, a drama of corporate corruption inspired by the political thrillers he grew up loving.
It is a genre film, but it's a genre film in the style of the films that we all like, the films between, you know, 65 and 75 in the world of Parallax View, and films that have a social conscience.
Clooney's performance received one of the film's 7 Academy Award nominations, with Tilda Swinton taking home the Oscar for Best Supporting Actress.
I do everything from shoplifting housewives to bent congressmen, and you're gonna kill me?
Clooney produced the gripping true-life drama Argo, and even had the selflessness to step aside for the good of the picture.
Originally, I was gonna play the part, and then Ben called up. He said, I wanna direct it, and I was like, great. And he goes, and I wanna play the part. I was like,
we're shooting in Iran.
Iran with an N.
Yeah.
And he did a beautiful job with that and won Best Picture.
Clooney's 2nd Oscar, this time as producer, capped off a remarkable run, and the future is bright with his Smokehouse Pictures slated to produce new films for Warner Brothers.